Welcome back to Let's Play the Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch, the Legend of Heroes Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, now beginning Chapter 3, Shadow. We're in Bolt, and we're going to be heading to the Shrine of Igunis. Got a little sidetracked with the whole Galaga giant whale monster thing that was actually controlled by a parasitic creature who we defeated last episode. But someone apparently conjured that parasitic creature. I didn't know how we knew it was conjured. It could just been existing in the world, but whatever. So someone else is behind this. And south out of town here is the path to the Shrine of Igunis. And that's not the map, that's magic. Oh, there, the Serpent's Backbone. Right, we gotta follow the Serpent Mountains or Mountain Range, whatever. And there's Igunis there. But before we leave, we're gonna talk to everybody, because that's what we do. Although our bunny is mad. Let's observe. Oh, in a good mood. Doesn't look hungry yet, but it's... Oh, now you're in a good mood. Okay. Morrison says, please stop by Castle Amdara and let us know how you are doing. Please, please. And Alfred, the way to the Serpent Tongue is pretty rough, so don't haste to get there. Well, we're going to haste a little bit. And she's asleep. Yurio says, Ms. Magisa, please rest yourself. She helped with her magics. Really tuckered her out. Oh, this is, what's his name? Lodi. Yuri says, I wish we could have traveled together more. Well, perhaps we will meet again. Now you're in a bad mood. Now you're hungry. Oh, jeez. What do we have the most of? Angel food. Shielding food. I wonder how much the shielding food really helps. Yeah, let's use one, because... Actually, agility... No, not shielding. Agility, I mean. Boost your party's speed during combat. It gulps down the agility food. Actually, I like that. A lot more than... what we have been giving it. Normal mood. Okay. So, as you... probably know, if you've been watching, that makes your pet show up during the next combat, and in this case gives you a buff to agility. In other cases, it'll launch some kind of attack spell on your enemies. Pretty interesting. It all worked out in the end. I'm so glad. I'm so thankful to you. Thanks. So thankful that you say thanks after saying you're thankful. You did a great job. Thank you very much. How wow. I feel safe now. I can finally invite guests over. Thank you so much. Let's do that. I always hit it again just in case they say a second thing. Sometimes they do. Selling anything new? No. As expected, the great soldiers of Ambush drove Galaga back to the sea. Now, you don't give us any credit for that, do you? What a shame. Shame on you, sir. Chris says, Yurio, Igunis is not that way. Can't get through there. And that's a dead end. Isn't this the second part of town? Let's talk to him. We sell pet food blessed by chapel priests. Oh, we don't need any more pet food. Do you say anything else? Looks like he has dollar signs for eyes. Being from the chapel, I'm happy to hear Ms. Magisa is doing a wonderful job. Oh, wait. Whoa! Full cure potion? Our first time seeing that. A potion containing a full cure spell heals all damage. Yes, I'm assuming if you're down to one hit point, it will put you all the way up. That's awesome. Now I can return to my fishing. I'm going to make up for what I lost. So this is the second part, right. What? They drove Galaga away? How did they do that? You helped too? Good job. Thank you so much. I said thank you so much. She doesn't sell the full cure potions. Pieces have been restored in Bolt again. It's great news. Pet is showing off somewhat. I wish you could read that book. Still in a bad mood though. No one's in these tents anymore. What? A remind potion. Let me remind myself of the remind potion. It's a better than the mind potion. Slightly. Moderately. Wow, I'm almost full of those too. I love the sound of the torches or braziers, whatever. No one in here. I think I just talked to her. Back here. What? The Galaga's incident has been settled? Great. Thanks, guys. Can't sit around doing nothing. Gotta prepare to do fishing. I'm gonna go catch a lot of fish. Thank you for letting me know. I don't know if there's anyone up here. Nope. Makes sense as there's no one there. Because they don't have to watch out for Galaga anymore. Injured soldiers have already headed to Amdera. Most of the soldiers will return to Amdera soon. Bolt was never a town that put up soldiers. Hi there. Galaga has just returned to the sea. It sure was a gentle creature. I guess what made him ferocious was that parasitic monster hidden inside. Ferocious, I say. Hey guys! I'm sure you know this, but don't go there. Because of the attack, you don't know when and where it will fall apart. What will fall apart? Galaga has returned to the sea. We were so surprised when it started moving, but Magisa said that it returned to normal, so we let it go. I don't think it will ever attack the villages again. Yeah, okay. I'm always talking about what will fall apart. Oh yeah, the was one of those canned priests there. He's no longer there. He was just selling stuff too. Oh, you are friends of His Majesty. Good work. I heard about your great deeds, as might be expected of the king's friends. You're heading to Igunis, right? Bon voyage. This road will take you directly to Igunis. Alright, hi. We rested and stuff. Here's the defense. This will give us better attack speed. It's not as impressive as the, you know, the attack, like the elemental attacks. But we just have so many of those, I figured we should use them. Once you get to 10, a quantity of 10, it won't stack anymore. It won't let you have any more. So, what are we gonna do? Just attack, I guess. Fanged wolves. Actually, here. Let's do the cheer. I don't like being a two-person party. Nice. Oh, I missed. Alright, so what do we got here? Port City Bolt, South Igunis, 1472 Milos, Amdara, 2988 Milos. I will fight many fang wolves, I'm guessing. Owie! What is up there? Is this something that the tree's just glitching out? Alright. Alright, I'll fight you. Now she's full. I'm just gonna do a finishing move on. Wait, that's not her. Hit that one. Yeah, finishing move on wolf number B. Watch me work my magic. They would like mix up the enemies a little more. Now Yurio gets his finishing move, Sword Fang. We're just gonna do cheer for Chris here. Two punch. We're back to getting like small amount of gold and stuff. That was needed. Need a drink. These battles make me very thirsty. Hope you pick up another party member soon. I really like having, you know, at least three or four party members. Ouch! Ah, oh, don't miss. Eh. Oh, jeez. Okay. I'm careful with Chris. She loses hit points so quickly. Oh, look at that. So now in the second part. So there's Serpent's Backbone, Serpent's Backbone. Igunis should be the next zone. Oh, we got some enemies coming up here. The Surtur Dragon and Fang Wolf. I'm not sure which is more dangerous. Fang Wolves. We only one-shot him on once, I think, right? Let's do a finishing move on this Fang Wolf. And a finishing move on the other Fang Wolf. Yeah, it is not too tough. And just the fact that it's a kind of dragon makes you think it's tough, but... Alright, so Chris levels up to 16. And has learned Magic Shield. And Yurio levels up. And a little better... Wait. I wanna look at... What? That button wouldn't work. What the hell? I want to see the description of this magic shield. Boosts a character's magical defense. Well, that makes sense. Alright, we'll fight you now. A Surtur Dragon and whatever else. Same as last time. I was trying to one-shot and kill that thing. It's doing Wind Cutter. I do not approve. Ah. Okay, the dragon's out. Down to the last Fang Wolf. We got spicy food and a cure potion. Nice. I don't think we can carry cure potions, though. Don't we already have... Yeah, 10 of them. Did we use one? Huh, maybe. I don't know. We got a spicy food. Fire-based attacks. Okay. Are you hungry yet? Probably not. Takes a while. Glad you're in a good mood for once. I was hoping I one-shot that thing. How dare you? Yeah, let's heal them both up. Just be on the safe side. Oh, wrong person. So... saving. Always weirds me out how it's so quiet on the screen. Okay, then. Oh, wait. He's got a finishing move. Do it on one of the wolves. Hey! How dare you? It's like it knew we were gonna do a finishing move on it. Well, since this thing is right here, take care of it. Wind cutter again. Nice. Okay. Finishing move on Fang Wolf A. I like that wind cutter very much. Ah. Yeah, I guess I'll hear both of them. Chris says, this mountain road is really steep. Yeah, the Shrine of Igunis is so high up. Ooh, we made it. It's nice to get to a shrine again. I feel like it's been so long. Oops. What's your issue now? You hungry now? You're not hungry yet, so I'll praise you. Look at that. A structure. Just looking around a little. Oh, who's this? Looks like he was skating along. Bongo says, hey guys, you're gonna regret it if you leave without looking in the magic mirror. Didn't say we're leaving, just looking around. This is the Shrine of Fire. There are only 5 shrines in the world. Okay. He won't let us go. That's funny. Oh. Stimulants, we don't need any of that. Okay. Wonder if we'll find any more books to read around here. Peruna says, this is our 40th wedding anniversary. Thanks to our health, we are able to travel by ourselves. Don't overdo it. Please take care of yourselves. Ragu says, there's a rumor that Galga will come attack us. I wonder what is going on. Chris says, don't worry about Galga anymore. It's back in the Sea of Bolt. Really? That's good to hear. I am thinking about going to see the Sea of Bolt with my wife. Good to hear. Are you talking to yourself about good to hear? That's interesting. Can we? Okay, we can't walk. There, that's a wall. Okay. Hi. Yogumu says, oh, you guys are on a pilgrimage even though you are so young. Yo-Yo says, that's the custom of our village. The custom? Are you two from Ragpick Village? How'd you know? Chris says. How long ago was it? We had a pilgrim boy from Ragpick stay at our house. Who could it be? Yo-Yo says, I wonder. I bet it's been a while since it was before our time. I think... well... Bob... no... Rob, that doesn't sound right. Raj, Yo-Yo and Chris say in unison. Raj, that's right. That's the one. How's he doing? He's doing well, Chris says. Yo-Yo says he is a good carpenter. He used to play with me a lot. Good. Anyhow, it is such a coincidence to meet someone from Ragpick Village during my trip again. I would love to visit Ragpick Village if I had a chance. Okay. Who else is about? Books! Yeah! Oh, look. Yeah, of fire, right? The Shrine of Fire. I see, like, molten lava or something over there. Toria says, hi there. People look forward to visiting the library and the shrines. There are convenient things such as books that travelers have left, guest books from the visitors, and helpful books. Once I go to the library, I could spend all day there. Mickey says, no matter how many times I read the book about Ortega's dragon slaying, I don't get tired of... it? I don't get tired of... Alright, let's see what books we have. Oh! Another Feral Cure Potion. Sweet. It'll be like forever till we even use it. There is a book that says The Great Sorcerer Ortega, the Great Dragon Slayer. Yorio says, "This is about Ortega, the great sorcerer. I've read this before." The great sorcerer Ortega, the great dragon slayer. The great sorcerer Ortega raised his staff calmly, then he transformed into the giant gallant dragon and went up in the sky. Soon, Ortega, flying higher than any other dragon, zoomed down, blowing fire at the other dragons. The other dragons fell one after another and disappeared into the bottom of the sea. This is the Ortega's dragon-slaying story which has been passed down. Cool, Yurio says. Oh, he's found something. There was a guest book. There was a message written in distinctively poor handwriting. Yurio tried to read it. "I saw a magic mirror of the fire shrine today. They say that only children can see the magic mirror. I feel bad for grown-ups. Therefore, I am going to describe it for them. First, the fire rose up, crackling and roaring. Then it got dark, and I saw beautiful stars. They were twinkling." Yurio says, "Crackling, roaring, twinkling? What is he talking about? Who wrote it?" Yurio looked for the signature. It said at the end, "Raj of Ragpig Village has come." It's Raj's. Chris says, "Oh my goodness. It's Raj all over." Well, this one has an exclamation mark. The book says, "The Shrine in Igunis, its origin." Yo-Yo takes the book in his hand. "The Shrine in Igunis is one of the five shrines in Tirasweel, along with the ones of Dean, Tagura, Shifuul, and Oldos. The shrine presides over fire, and its magic mirror is subject to worship by visiting pilgrims. The mirror is said to have been used in the past by witches and monks to help them understand their own minds as part of their training. According to legend, once upon a time there was a battle between the giant and the great serpent crossing over the countries. The serpent lost and became the big mountain range called Backbone of the Great Serpent, which lies south of Ambush." Interesting. How do I get in that room? I go this way. Kator the Trader says, "I am Kator the Trader. I've got a variety of goods. Do you want to come and take a look at them?" Yes. You got potions. Ooh, what's this? Feruru Potion. A tasty concoction that cures all negative effects. Okay. I'll take three of them. Yes, I am sure. A Safi Volume 6 Nightmare. And a Power Ring plus 2. And a Magic Ring plus 2. Okay. 1,000 platinum. Okay, let's do the exchange thing. Alright, we have plenty of money then. Alright, so I will buy Safi Volume 6 and Power Ring plus 2. Alright, we want to go into equipment. Because Yurio has the Power Ring plus 1. We're going to switch it. Attack 109. Power Ring plus 2. Attack will be 114. I'm going to hold on to the other rings in case we get some more party members that can make use of them. I mean, I'm wondering if one of the our past party members will rejoin us. Or we're going to find someone completely new. I don't know. Alright, so now we can read Safi Volume 6. Nightmare. A shadow moved across the candlelight. The dagger reflects an eerie light. It was a nightmare she had seen time and time again. She knew it was a dream, but she also knew she couldn't avert her eyes from the cruel sight. A shadow wielded a sword in madness. Run! She must have said this 1,000 times. Red splatters of blood splashed onto the wall. Flowing blood took the life of her loved one. She saw herself when she was young, standing vacantly in front of the dead body. She remembered Brad's words after the duel. Hatred in the sword will bring you down. The young girl lifted the blood-covered sword. The girl had firmly shut lips, bundled brunette hair, and chilly blue eyes that scared anyone who saw them. No! Sapphire was released from the nightmare by her own scream. Interesting. Okay. That looks like a potion we can pick up. Alas, we cannot. Oh. Another recure potion. How many do we have now? Almost full. But I'm gonna call it an episode here, guys. Stay tuned for next episode when we actually visit the... another full cure. I think we have three now. We're finding a lot of good things for us. Three, wow. So stay tuned for next episode when we actually visit the Shrine of Igunis. Until then, thanks for watching, and always, seek adventure.